This episode of How to Spin Yarn has been brought to you by SpinOlution, state-of-the-art spinning wheels proudly made by families in the USA. And by My Local Wool. Find farms, festivals, artisans, and shops near you by visiting mylocalwool.com.
Welcome back to How to Spin Yarn, and this tutorial is called PUFFED. I'm going to show you some of the fibers we'll be working with. I have some dark charcoaly brown Wensleydale and some white Wensleydale. I have some sequins. You can also try ribbon or, anything. I've got some alpaca roving. I have some other brown alpaca wool roving, some black roving. I've got a bit of bricolage art bat, some rolags from Classy Squid, some sparkle. So we are just going to play with all of these and create a beautiful puffed yarn. This yarn is similar to a thick and thin yarn, but you control which sections you want to be thick, and it's a great way for showcasing fibers that are special to you and little embellishments. So let's get started. The spinning wheel that I'll be doing this tutorial on is called a SpinOlution Hopper, and this wheel has the 16 ounce bobbin on it. I've already got some yardage on here for a cast on or bind off in case we decide to knit or crochet this fiber. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the rolags as my base, and then I'm going to embellish the rolag with different textures. So we'll just begin drafting out the rolag. And maybe I'll throw on some art bat as a puff. Just lay the fiber on top and let it wrap around. And you can secure it in the front or in the back. And that is our first puff. Isn't that fun? Make sure that the puffs you create can fit easily through your orifice. Even though I have an open orifice, it's possible that these puffs can get snagged. So I'm just gonna manually wind it on just to make sure that it gets on safely. There we go. And let's find something else. Maybe we'll make a black puff. If you find your puffs are too loosey-goosey, try running your fingers over it to kind of sculpt it onto the yarn. Maybe I'll do a brown puff here. And what I am doing to keep the yarn from getting too over twisted is I'm drafting plenty. I'm pre-drafting plenty behind. And that way, when I add the puff, all of the twist that's building up here, I can just slide it back once I'm ready for it. It seems if you break your fiber and then just let the ends wrap on, that seems like the easiest way to get your fiber to catch. And feel free to kind of draft it out and let it wrap and draft it out. And let it wrap. And so now all that twist I can bring back into the fiber I've already pre-drafted. I want to try a puff of locks. Let's do some of these beautiful dark locks. Making an entire yarn with puffs of locks would be gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. So just let the locks lay on top of the yarn until they catch. And just allow them to wrap. Tuck the ends in. Isn't that pretty, pretty, pretty? I am going to let some of the twist travel back, and I'm going to wrap this one on so it doesn't get snagged by my orifice hook. What else should we do? I loved the way that puff of art bat looked. This is a great technique for if there's an art bat you have that you love and you just want to showcase bits of texture from it. Now, I have no fiber here, so I'm in a dangerous spot. What I'm going to do is core spin over the end and attach it like so, so it's nice and secure. Okay, let's do a sparkle puff. Everyone loves a sparkle puff. You could do a whole yarn with just sparkle puffs. Sparkle puff. What else do we have? Let's see. We'll do another little puff of locks. Maybe another little pack of puffs. Make sure you have, I would say medium twist, because you do want enough twist to allow the puff to really become secure on your base yarn, but not so much twist that your base yarn gets really crunched up with twist as you're spinning. Okay, so here's an example of what not to do. My hook grabbed onto that last puff and shredded it. So we're gonna come back and fix it. I'm going to scooch it forward, pull out what I can that's not very drafted, and just rewrap it. There we go. And now, so I don't repeat mistakes of the past, I'm going to take it off my hook, manually wind it on to the bobbin, and keep going. Now I'm doing this very exaggerated so that you can see how these are made. Sparkle poof. Everybody loves a sparkle poof. Except my hook. My hook does not like sparkle poof. That's just super fun. Thank you. Okay, what else do we have here that we can play with? Let's do this rolag. It's so fun to spin. Super easy to draft. I think using a rolag or some type of fiber that's really easy to draft makes this a lot better because you don't have to worry about drafting and adding poofs at the same time. Let's do a raw cormo poof. Fluff it up into a cormo cloud. I don't think we need that much. Nice. Okay, let's do some more curly locks. Okay, now I'm using the art bat as the base. I'm going to do a flax poof. What else should we do? Here comes a darker section of the art bat, which seems like a perfect place to add a poof of curls, white curls, so that we can see the difference. Ooh, that gives me an idea. I had some sparkle that kind of grabbed onto this. So I'm gonna take some sparkle and just wrap it in sparkle. So kind of a poof on poof. Here, I'll bring this so that you can see. Possibilities are crazy fun. Crazy fun. I'm so excited to see what you make with this style of yarn. If you're noticing mid poofing, that your twist is going up into the back of your fiber and it's creating a large glob of thick fiber, stop your poof, untwist your fiber, draft back so that you can take some of that twist and bring it back like that, and then pinch really hard because you have this pre-drafted section behind because you don't want any twist to get in there. Pinch this hard, finish your poof, and then slide your hand back. So we're going to finish our poof. And then slide our hand back to get that twist to travel backwards and not get all clumped up in one spot. I can hear you saying, give me another sparkle poof. Maybe the yarn is saying that. We'll do some moving on top. Another troubleshooting. If you start getting to the point where you're like, whoa, this is more poof than I actually wanted, keep a hold on your yarn, draft off what you don't want, bring your yarn back again, and then finish your poof. That way you aren't stuck with spinner's regret of, oh, I should not have put that much fiber right there. I think it's time to play with that lace and try little embellishments. I don't know if this will work. It might be too heavy. I'm going to take the ends of the lace and tuck it in between my fiber, like this. And twist it so that the sparkly side is going to be on the outside. And then we're going to see what happens here. That's not bad. The sparkled. Let's get the fiber off of it though. Kind of a sparkly beaded look. I don't want the whole thing though, so I'm just gonna break it. Now to cover over the end, I'm going to take some fiber, pinch it to the base of the poof, and core spin it over that end, locking it. Oh, too much twist was in the top and it broke. Too much twist. Too thin. Too much twist. Too exaggerated a poof for the yarn that we had going on. So I'm going to say that this was not meant to be. Sometimes you can try and it just doesn't work. Okay. We'll do a silk base and put a black poof on it. I guess I'm calling these poofs, and the technique I was originally going to call it was puffs. Are they puffs or poofs? Maybe they're puffs. My twist has gotten all the way back here. So I'm gonna get it out because I don't want my yarn to get that thick. With silk, it's so hard because it's such a long staple that once it starts traveling down, it's like, it's hard to find. It's hard to break it. I don't know. There, I guess we're gonna have to just, pull sections of it off at a time. There we go. And now we can draft this back, but I don't want to untwist it too much or else I will lose stability in my puff, poof, whatever we're calling it. Okay, let's try that again. There we go. I'm going to do another raw Cormo puff. I'm going to pre-draft all this fiber behind so that I've got plenty for the twist to travel up into. And now I'll hold it tight so that none of that twist gets back in here. And get this Cormo attached. It will just naturally grab on. But I do think that's too much, so I'm going to pull some of it off and then keep going with this. There we go. And then whoop. And that twist comes all the way back to balance it out. This yarn does need a lot of twist to stay secure. Let's do a puff of locks. My hook tore apart my lock poof. So I'm going to bring this back and repair it. There we go. I don't want to put too much twist in it though, or else I'll make the thinnest parts of the yarn fragile. Because too much twist makes it really, really hard and almost brittle. And then it will snap. Okay, we'll just make a couple more. And then move on to something else. If you are having problems getting too much twist behind here, feel free to break off your roving so the twist can't travel anywhere else. And then finish your little puffed section. And then if you have way too much twist, you can always pinch right behind the puff so that it stays stable. And then let the yarn go and take out all that extra twist. And then let the puff go. And that way the puff doesn't really unravel much, but you don't have all the hard knots and bumps in your yarn. I think that's good. It broke. So that means we're done. I'll show you what we have. Kind of hard to see the puffs, but I'll take them off the bobbin and take some pictures for the website so you can see what they look like. But it is definitely a super fun art yarn technique and also excellent for plying.